broadcasting from the greatest castle in the world, in the County of Lawrence, NCTV 45.
At our law firm, we see you. Come see us at lgkg.com.
NCTV 45, The Train, anytime on your time.
Hello and welcome to another Focus NC. And this Focus NC, very, very important. Might be one of the most important ones that we've done. In recent days, have taken a look at different colleges, universities. I watch different news shows, not just one, but, you know, whether it's the major media or, you know, maybe conservative, a little bit more media, liberal, conservative. And what interests me is the knowledge of our students, the knowledge of society between right and wrong. Now, as I was at one university, and I usually like to leave these things nameless, only because I don't want to offend the guilty. There was an interesting article, and it focused on the debate that surrounds Trump's wall and immigrants remain vilified. Well, what a terrible abuse of the facts. He goes on to say in his article that everybody here basically was an immigrant. Okay, I could agree with that. Even the Native Indians, how far do you want to go back? You know, there's a theory that the continents were separated at one time by water, but before that they were all together. And the people that came here came over a bridge, a land bridge. Just saying, so everybody could be an immigrant. Okay. Then he goes on and he talks about the Statue of Liberty and being a beacon and the quote, "Give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses yearning to be free." Yep, that's what it says. No problem. But now comes where his facts get a little bit sketchy. I'm going to take the Italians were hated and regarded as foreigners by the Protestant majority. Okay. There was anti-Catholic sentiment. Okay. That manifested in violence against the newly settled Italians. The Irish were too resented after fleeing the famine and political upheaval in their land. They were stereotyped as, and he goes on to say, brutes, rapists. Jewish immigrants were hated historically for a slew of stereotypes, unfounded accusations. Okay? Now, okay. That's where the facts end. Now, let me kind of give you some background information after we take this break on what this guy's writing about.
On Target Printing, 1319 West State Street. No job is too big or too small. Turnaround on most jobs, 24 hours. We make you look good on paper.
Back, and we're talking about this article in a local college publication. He goes on to say that now the Mexicans and Middle Easterns are the new next hated group. Trump's preached separatism, since he was on the campaign trail. Now, hold on one second. You left out this little kind of a fact here, bud. When people came to Ellis Island, they were documented immigrants. Some were sent back. Yeah, some were sent back because they were sick or something wasn't exactly right. And each one that came in was documented. And there was a number from each country that we would accept. Yeah, hold on. You missed the whole thing. So when you talk about Donald Trump, I wonder if you had a problem when you were in grade school. In other words, if the teacher said, don't talk, that was the rule. Don't talk. And if you broke the rule, then there was a consequence. If the law is you come to this country, but you have to go through this system, and you sneak across the border without a passport, without any documentation, then you broke the law. You left that out here. This whole spot. I suggest you take some logic, because the logic in your article isn't a trail of separatism and a trail of lying based on American values. American values are, we are a land of laws, we follow the laws, and if you don't, you pay the consequence. Once again, a liberal view coming out of one of my, what I would call, respected higher institutions. Higher learning institutions. This editorial needed all the help in the world. Too bad it left out the facts. Now, hold on to that thought. We're going to be back, and I'm going to talk about another example.
Today's programming furnished by a grant from Joseph's Supermarket. Special thanks to Joseph's. The Pokeberry Exchange at 41 North Mercer Street has gifts galore that'll make you want to explore. Lamps, homemade lamps of every shape and color that will excite any room in your house. Wind chimes hang from the door to give that sweet sound. Sweet soaps and teas, embroidered towels, and much more. It's the Pokeberry Exchange. It's yours to explore.
Back. And when I was in college, I had a class, Rational Foundations of the Catholic Faith. And one of the questions that it asked, was it rational to believe that Jesus Christ existed? And they went back and they proved through documentation that he existed. Now, that being said, one of the questions that came up was a major university, and it was ironic because a little under two months ago, I was there. They have covered their picture of Christopher Columbus. Wrong answer. You know, there's been so much talk about Christopher Columbus and the Vikings, whether it was Leif Erikson or somebody coming here first. The difference is the Vikings did not cause the land to be settled. There weren't colonies set up that continued on for years and years and years, to my knowledge. Christopher Columbus sailed the ocean blue in 1492, and he brought Christianity to the New World. Now, as of late, there's been some question on Christopher Columbus. Now, I find it very upsetting for a number of different reasons. One of those being that we are conveniently ignoring facts. Once again, Christopher Columbus, by discovering the New World, and I did say discover because up at that time, they still didn't believe it was a New World. Christopher Columbus, by discovering the New World, went back, told others, and they began to come here with settlements. Striving for religious freedom and freedom of people yearning to be free. With respect to others' opinions. When we don't respect others' opinions, it becomes like, I don't know, the Salem witch trials, that may or may not, I haven't read up enough on Salem witch trials to know what exactly they were talking about. I can respect a liberal opinion that of somebody, as long as there's logic in it, that says, hey, we have to do this and this, you know, we got to try and help this group. Yeah, I'm there. However, to attack Christopher Columbus on only one narrative and not what he's done across the board would be like attacking other ethnic groups and saying, well, oh, this man cheated on his wife. He couldn't be a good leader. And this person did this. he couldn't be a great leader. In town, we have a church called St. Vitus. Back in Italy, it's called St. Vito. Vitus was a Roman soldier. Roman soldiers did many bad things. Some of them did good things. Some of the saints did bad things and changed as time went on and did good things, and we recognize them. Our recognition of Christopher Columbus is right. And I will stand as an Italian American and say, by your attacks on that, I have to ask the question, are you racist? Are you discriminating against Italians? That's what the left would be asking. So I have to ask. Now for Focus NC, I'm Angelo Parada. Here's hoping you have a nice day. Remember, we're available anytime on YouTube.